Hello student, today we will discuss how to draw plane using Miller indices in the positive axis as well as in the negative axis, or we can say positive planes and negative planes. So before going to plane, so let us first discuss how we fix coordinate when in a cube or unit set. So here I have drawn a cube having side A, B, C, D, E, F, G. The center point is H. So if O is the origin, then obviously the coordinate of the origin is 0, 0, 0. But when it comes to A, A point is lying on the x-axis. So the coordinates are 1, 0, 0. But at C, it cut only y-axis. So the coordinate is 0, 1, 0. And at this point, it cut only z axis. So the F point have coordinates 0, 0, 1. But when it comes to B, it lies where the value of x is 1 and the value of y is 1, but the value of z is 0. So the coordinate of B is equal to 1, 1, 0. Similarly for D, here it is 0, 1, 1 because it has only y coordinate and z coordinate. And when it comes to G, then the coordinate of G coordinate of G's are 1, 0, 1 because here the y coordinate is 0. It has only x value and z value. But at this point E, the coordinates are 1, 1, 1 because it has x value, y value as well as z value. And if we discuss about the midpoint of the cube, that is H, then it is half, half, half because it has half x value, half y value and half z value. Now coming to the faces, if you consider the first face A, B, E, G, the center point of this will have the coordinates 1 because it lied in the front face, so it has x value 1 but y value half and z value half. Similarly, for the face EBCD, this one, the center value will be, here the y value is 1, but the x value is half and z value is half. So it is half, 1, half. Similarly, the center point of the face GFDE, here the z value is 1, but the x value is half and y value is half. So the coordinates are half, half, 1. Similarly, if you find out the coordinates for the face AOFG, matlab, this face, the center value of the coordinates, kya hoga? X is half, z is half, but y is 0. So this is half, 0, half. Similarly, for the face ABCO, here the coordinate will be x half, y half, but z 0. X half, y half, z 0. Similarly, for OCFD, here the y value is half, z value is half, but x is 0. So if you want to define the coordinate in the negative x-axis, then extend the cube like this, and this, the coordinate of this point on the face 1, 2, 3, 4, it's like the center of this face 1, 2, 3, 4. The coordinates are y will be minus 1, but x is plus half, z is plus half. Similarly, the center of face 3, 4, 5, 0 is positive half for x, negative y, but z is 0. So here the coordinates are half, minus half, 0. Similarly, for the face 1, 2, 7, 8. When you find the coordinates for the center point of this face, then z is positive 1, x is half positive x axis, but y is minus half. So this is half, minus half, and 1, and so on. So like this we can define the coordinates of the points that lying on the cube. Similarly, coordinates are basically represented like this. It is closed by the parenthesis and separated by commas. But if you want to represent the direction, direction is same, but you have to join the origin with that particular point, and that shows the direction. This is the direction for 111, this is the direction for 110, this is the direction for 010, and so on. But it has to be enclosed in a square bracket without commas, like this. Let us discuss how to draw plane using Miller indices. So Miller indices basically represented like this, the coordinates HKL. HKL are called the Miller indices. These are basically the whole numbers enclosed by the parenthesis and used to indicate crystallographic plane, where H equal to the reciprocal of the intercept made by the plane along x-axis, K represents the reciprocal of the intercept made by the plane along y-axis, L represents the reciprocal of the intercept made by the plane along z-axis. Now let us first draw the plane 100. So the Miller indices in this case is 100. So in order to find the intercept, we have to take reciprocal of the Miller indices. So 1/1, 1/0, 1/0. So the intercepts are 1, infinity, infinity. That means this plane is parallel to y and x axis both, but it cut the x axis. So if you draw such type of plane, then this will represent it like this, because here the x value is 1 and it is parallel to y axis as well as z axis. So let me draw this plane. That means here the x value is 1, so this is represented by this plane, because this plane is parallel to y axis as well as the z axis. Similarly, if you want to plot a plane whose Miller indices are 0, 1, 0, then here the y value is 1, but it is parallel to y x axis as well as z axis. So y value is 1 for this plane only, and it is parallel to y axis as well as z axis. So this plane represents 0, 1, 0. Similarly, if you want to plot a plane 0, 0, 1, means here the z value is 1. That means this plane cut only the z axis, but it is parallel to x as well as y. So this plane has z value 1 and it is parallel to x axis as well as y axis. So this is 0, 0, 1 plane. Next plane is 1, 1, 0. The Miller indices are 1, 1, 0. So in order to find intercept, we have to take reciprocal of that. So 1 by 1, 1 by 1, 1 by 0. So the intercept equal to 1, 1, infinity. That is, it is parallel to z-axis. So parallel to z-axis means, here the x value is 1, y value is 1. Here also the x value is 1, y value is 1. So join these two points. And this plane is parallel to z-axis. So this represents 1, 1, 0 plane. Similarly, if you want to plot a plane having Miller indices 1, 1, 1. So here the Miller indices are 1, 1, 1. So the intercept is reciprocal of the Miller indices. So 1 by 1, 1 by 1, 1 by 1. So the intercepts are coming to be 1, 1, 1. That means it cut all three axes x, y, z. So here the x value is 1, here the y value is 1, here the z value is 1. If you join this plane, then this is a required plane having value 1, 1, 1. So let us redraw those planes. So 1, 1, 0 plane. So here the x value is 1, y value is 1. Here is also x value is 1, y value is 1. So join these two points and mark like this. So this plane is parallel to z axis. If you have to draw this plane, then simply you can interchange the axis. It is the easiest method to draw this plane. Here y is infinity, so take y here, z here. Similarly, if you want to draw 0, 1, 1 plane, then take y here and x here. Then in the same figure, we can draw all these three planes by interchanging the axis only. Now we will draw the negative planes. Negative planes means 1 bar 0, 0. If this is 1, 0, 0, then 1 bar must be the plane which will lie behind this, because that plane must be passing through the origin here. And we know that from the significance of the Miller indices, if some plane is passing through the origin, then we can draw the plane which is parallel to that. So in order to draw that plane, we will shift the origin from one place to the other. Let us compare these two figures. Here this plane is 100, and here we have to draw 1 bar 0 0. For this case, the origin is lying here. Now shift this origin from here to this place. So if you shift the origin here, then this plane represent 1 bar 0 0, because now the origin is here. So this is minus x, and it is parallel to y as well as z. So this represent 1 bar 0 0. Let us draw 0 1 bar 0. 0 1 bar 0, bar represents that the plane cut the axis along the negative side. So now in order to draw this plane, compare this plane with this one. This is 0 1 0. Now we have to draw 0 1 bar 0. So 1 bar is along the y axis. Now if you want to draw this plane by extending figure to this side, then draw a cube here, and then this side will represent minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0. But it is very difficult when it comes to three dimensions, that is 1 bar, 1 bar, 1 bar. So it is wise to shift origin. So in this case, the origin is here. Now shift the origin from this place to this place. Now here z axis lies here, y axis is this, and this is your x axis. Now this plane represent your 0, 1 bar 0, because this is minus y and it is parallel to x as well as z. So this is 0, 1 bar 0. Similarly, if you want to plot 0, 0, 1 bar, that means here the plane cut the z axis along the negative side. So compare this figure with 0, 0, 1. So 0, 0, 1, this plane represent your 0, 0, 1. Now if you want to draw this one, for this case the origin is here, so now we will shift the origin from here to here. So now this value will represent minus z, this is your x, and this is your y. So this plane will represent your 0, 0, 1 bar. Similarly, if you want to draw 1 bar, 1 bar, 0. 1 bar, 1 bar, 0 is the Miller indices. So intercept will be what? Intercept is 1 by minus 1, 1 by minus 1, 1 by 0. So this is equal to minus 1, minus 1, infinity. That is, it is parallel to z axis. Now we have already drawn the plane 1, 1, 0. But here it is 1 bar, 1 bar, 0. So for 1, 1, 0, the origin lying here at this place. So now if you shift this origin from here to this place, that means from here to this place, now this value is minus x, this value is minus y. And the same plane will work as minus 1, minus 1, 0. By shifting the origin from one place to the other. Now, let us draw 1 bar, 1 bar, 1 bar plane. So, we have already draw this plane 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1 means x value is 1, y value is 1, z value is 1. So, this is the plane represent 1, 1, 1. Now, in order to draw 1 bar, 1 bar, 1 bar. So, now you have to shift the origin from this place. That means from this place to this place. This is our new origin. So, by shifting the origin to this place, now the value of z is minus 1. This is minus x, minus y, and this is minus x. So, the same plane represent minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, or 1 bar, 1 bar, 1 bar. Just shift the origin to this place. So, let us take one or two examples more. If you want to draw 1, 1 bar, 0. Now, bar is in the y coordinate. So, y has to be negative. So, shift the origin only along the y axis. So, from here to here. So, if you shift the origin from here to here, then here, now this is your z, this is your x. So, this x is positive, z is positive, but y is negative for this plane. So, the same plane of 1, 1, 0 will represent 1 bar, 1, 1 bar 0 if we shift the origin to this place. Now, if you want to draw 1 bar 1, 0, now here the 1 bar is on the x axis. That means the x intercept is negative. So, you have to shift the origin such that the x value is only negative, but y and z is positive. So, shift the origin from this to this place. So, here and now if you draw the plane, then this is 1 bar, 1, and it is parallel to z. Now, let us draw some more planes. So, if you want to draw 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1 means Miller indices is 2, 3, 1. So, the intercept is 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 1. So, in this case, we have to take LCM. So, this is the intercept. Keep it like this only. Half 1 by 3 and 1. So, that means x value has value half. So, this is the point. Y value has the value 1 third. So, this is the point. 1 third of this length. And z is 1. So, z is here. So, this is the plane having Miller indices 2, 3, 1. Similarly, if you want to draw 2, 2, 2. So, 2, 2, 2 intercept is half, half and half. So, x half, y half, z half. So, this is the plane which is your having Miller indices 2, 2, 2. Similarly, if you want to draw 0, 0, 2. 0, 0, 2 is 1 by 0, 1 by 0 and 1 by 2. So, that is infinity, infinity and half. That means it has only z value half. So, this is the plane having this Miller indices. So, like this we can draw several planes using Miller indices. Always we have to take reciprocal of that so that this value can be accommodated within the unit cell. Here this 2, 3, 1 represents the multiple of this lattice parameter along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. If A is the lattice parameter along x-axis, B for y, C for z, then these are the multiple of A, B, C. We have to take reciprocal of that so that we can accommodate that plane in a single unit cell. Thank you so much.